Yeah, it's been a strange break, and you get, there's a lot of things that we had to address, and we had time to address them. Hopefully, that comes to fruition and results in us playing a lot cleaner and a lot more together. That's what we spent our time on. We're just gonna, as traditional, just start with Florida State today in terms of our prep, because I feel like our own product, we're great at times, but we haven't been consistently good. We've been great or we've been kind of bad, and we need to be consistently good. So that's where we tried to get to these last few days, and it's been intense and good. I mean, it's been one of those old school practices, repeated and repeated and repeated. So hopefully we had yesterday off, and now we're going to come back the next 2 days in straight prep.
All right, and as a reminder, please use the raise hand function if you have a question. Our first question comes from Michelle Kaufman. Go ahead, Michelle.
All right. Hey, Katie, thanks for taking the time. Can you give us just a couple of specifics? What are a couple of things that you felt needed to be addressed during this break that you had? And then the second thing is, what are you expecting from FSU? It always seems to be a great game between you and them, no matter what the records are. So those two questions. Thanks.
Well, without giving too much away, I really made a project of four things offensively and four things defensively that were non-negotiable. And that's what's just going to define us the rest of the year. I called people that I've coached with. I've called people I respect. It's like, you ever had 10 days off in late January, early February? Like, how do you structure this? I mean, it was really a challenge. We traditionally have this thing we call Camp Miami, but I took it a step further, split the team up into three different mini teams and had 2 days worth of competitions. And then after they got their little mini team and their placing and all that, I splintered the mini teams. And the very next thing they did after the one team won, one team got second, one team got third, was they had to compete one-on-one against the team that they had just spent 2 days competing with, just to make things difficult and unfair and challenging and all the stuff that knocks you off your course. And I really, it was a lot of, it was just necessary, because I think we just, to be consistently good, you got to fight through the hard times. You got to fight through a bad call. You got to fight through an injury or someone in foul trouble. I mean, all that stuff. And in this particular year, and with a lot of things that you can say, this isn't fair, this is hard, this is inconvenient, it's still a task, and it's still something that you get a life lesson out of. It's like, okay, you are correct, but we're not going to stop at you being right. Even if you are right, even if it is disadvantaged, even if we don't control the schedule, we don't control the testing and all this stuff, we in the moment need to be better. And that's basically the message.
And FSU, what do you expect from them?
Shoot, they can rebound. I'll tell you what. Oh my God. Oh my God. They are big in every position. I think they're going to have a height advantage in every position on us. And they play a very strong and physical style of basketball. Their last two games against two very physical teams, Wake Forest and North Carolina, they came at those two very physical teams with more physicality. So that's something that we have to prepare for and really have to answer.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from Wyatt Kopelman. Go ahead, Wyatt.
Coach, it seems like Destiny Harden hasn't had as big of a role as she did towards the first half of the season. How would you explain the rationale for that?
Right. I think Destiny would have a hard time, really saying the rationale to it. It's not rational. The kid works hard. She's in the gym. She's working on her game. You see it sometimes in coaching. It's this, like somebody like Destiny or somebody even like Bree Jackson. I mean, this time was their time. The disjointedness of having this pause is also an opportunity for someone who hasn't been on their games. And I think those two young ladies really took advantage of this time, and they really need to step up, because you talk about physical and physicality and our need for it. And those two really represent that for us.
Are there any more questions for Coach Meier? Go ahead, Michelle.
Katie, like you said, it's a strange year and these big breaks and all that, but how do you explain how your team played against Louisville and then how they played the very next game? What the inconsistency, like you were saying, how does that happen?
Well, I mean, that's why I think the easy answer is, well, you know, Georgia Tech sat there for 5 days and watched us play Louisville and got to Miami the same time we did.
Mm-hmm.
You know, with not having played against the number one team in the country the day, you know, the day before. Right. I mean, that's the schedule. So that's the easy answer, but that's not the one I accept. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's where I'm at. Like, my response to that is, well, we should have been pretty darn confident because we just battled and played really well. So it should have been advantage Miami. Like, don't flip it that way. And mm-hmm. I just think that's, there's a little escape clause in a lot of brains this year. Just say, well, you know, this happened to me and, you know, and I just, it's true. All right. But there's also a flip side to every, you can always turn it around. You can always make it a positive, and we just needed to get there. But how did we play? Louisville, you know, honestly, Georgia Tech played with a lot more desire to stay in a stance. They were really, really, really difficult to get by. And mm-hmm. we were able to, and we were fresher and we played better. But that was the difference in the game, in my opinion. India Banks could get to the basket against Louisville or generate stuff. And Georgia Tech saw that. They said before the game, wow, you guys did a great job of blah, 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 right? And so they weren't going to let that happen. And when that didn't happen, we stood around. And I mean, that's really, you know, that happens sometimes. But I think it was also credit to Georgia Tech because they watched that game, had tremendous respect for what we did and how we generated our offense. And they weren't going to let us get that.
Mm-hmm. Our last question comes from Isabella Didio. Go ahead, Isabella.
You're not going to tell Florida State that answer, are you?
Huh?
So don't tell Florida State that answer.
I'm not telling Florida State anything.
They're smart enough to know that too.
All right, go ahead, Isabella, with your question.
Hi, Coach. I have a COVID-related question. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering if you know of any plan for the student athletes to get vaccinated, or like, if you've heard anything about when the school might have the vaccine available for them.
Right. You know, I honestly, the last head coaches meeting, I was in practice. So I still have a meeting tomorrow to get the update of what I missed because that, so, and I, if that came up, I'm not aware of it. So I really don't have a comment.